All right, it's time to install the project, or let's say you create a new Next.js application. I'm on the Next.js.org. I head into docs, then the installation. Don't forget to go to the latest version. Currently, the latest version is Canary 15. 15 is not stable yet, but I'm not expecting too much surprises because most of the features that they have introduced, as soon as we get into them, I'll explain what's new in React 15, but most of the features that you see in this documentation will remain the same. So I go to installation, then it says that we need Node.js 18.18, the minimum requirements, and then one of these operating systems on Mac, so I'm good. And then by copying this npx create next app and running it in a terminal, you can have a new Next.js application. So let's run it. And then it's going to ask a couple of questions for me. I hit enter. My app sounds good. I need TypeScript, of course. ESLint, sure. Tailwind CSS. By default, it's inside, and you can choose to not install in Tailwind if you don't like it, but I go with yes. And then SRC directory, yes, I want. And app router, yes, it's recommended to use app router, the new way of routing in Next.js. I choose yes, and default one, no. And now it's trying to install the dependencies. And after a couple of seconds, depending on your internet connection, you will have the next application. So the name of the application was my app. It's created now in my app directory, cd my app, and I can run npm run dev, and now it's running. I can open this website and this application under port 3000 on localhost. So let me just open it in the browser, and here we go. It is the minimum Next.js application. It's running under this port. And if we want to take a look into the code, I will stop. I open it with VS Code, and let me find this. Yeah, here we go. This is the default project, as you can see. Let me maximize and zoom a little. As you can see, it consists of node modules, SRC with a page, some fonts here, and some configurations, package.json, Tailwind config, DS config, etc. So that's it. This is very good for a starting point. If you want to start simple, go ahead and use this command npx create next app. But there are some corner cases that you have to consider. For instance, here we don't have any kind of testing included in the project. So if you want, for instance, Jest, you have to install it manually by yourself. If you take a look inside the package.json, you can see there's no footprint of Jest and testing. And to do so, if we quickly jump to testing, you can see how you can add Jest or vtest to your project. Here it simply says that you could create your project with this example. So there are some kind of templates or boilerplates yet that you could choose, but since we don't have them now. What we can do is to manually add them. So the reason that I'm explaining is that other than simple installation project or the basic one, you can have other boilerplates that can be found here in this repository. If I go up one level, you can see the Next.js examples. There are a lot of examples, as you can see. I'm scrolling down, and with a lot of combinations you can have, for instance, with Torso. I don't know why is that. With TurboPack or with Sentry. Let's say with MSW, etc. So we just installed the basic one, but you could also use one of these. And to do so, what you can do is you can simply pick the name of this. Let's try it. So I go back to my terminal. And if I go back again, the same command npx create next app at some latest, and I can now choose example dash dash example, and then one of these templates that I prefer. For instance, I need auth, so I go with dash dash example with just auth, and then my app name. Yeah, you can go. This is my app 2, my app with auth. You can choose whatever you want. And it's trying to download. Yeah, it's working. And that's it. If I go inside this application and open it with VS Code, you can see now, let me zoom. It has other stuff in it. Next auth is installed inside the package JSON, and sometimes they have some other codes as well. Yeah, for instance, here they are doing some stuff in this route. Later we explain what is this kind of structure, but no worries. But yeah, here's the idea. Yeah, we can have other boilerplates based on your requirement. You can choose one of these. And there's also another option. These options that you see, they are good for a starting point and to investigate and dig more. But there's another option called TurboRepo that you can use. It's again under Verso. They are the creator of TurboRepo. And if I go to TurboRepo, you can see the first link, turbo.build, and then TurboRepo. And what is this? It's basically a build system for JavaScript and TypeScript code bases. And actually our project is in TypeScript, right? So it should work. And this is a high performance build system. So what it can do for you is it helps to have faster deployment in terms of building and some other features that it offers like caching. And to have a project with the Turbo Pack installed, you have two options. You can either add Turbo Pack to your existing project, or if you start fresh, you can just simply go into installation and create a new Turbo repo. And it's a monorepo project. It has its own architecture and its own kind of structure. And as you know, in the monorepo, we can have different packages, different applications in one code base. And what it offers that makes it unique, during build, it has a lot of optimizations like caching, so you never build something that hasn't been changed twice because it takes care of it. And also it offers remote building. So basically it's good to consider this repository as well. Let me create a project with this one. And yeah, as you can see, it comes with some other templates and boilerplates here. And you can choose one of these. If I click on them, you can see even more. Here, for instance, with npm, with next.js, with nest.js. And it's not connected directly to next.js. They are two separate concepts. But what it offers is a build system. It's a faster build system, especially for monorepo projects. So for our case, I go with yarn, for instance, and as you can see, they are maintaining them well. It's updated 4 days ago. To use this one, I have to go back again and run this command with yarn. So again, another terminal with yarn. I hit enter. Yes, and then I have to choose my project directory name. That's okay. And now we have one of these options. Oh, this one is new, by the way. I see it. It's a cool one. You can also take a look later, but I go for now with yarn. And now installing the dependencies. And meanwhile it's installing, you can also take a look here. If I go back again, yeah, actually here I have it open with yarn. It's kind of cloning this project, and you can before cloning you can take a look inside the source code, and as you can see it consists of two directories, apps and packages. Inside apps it has two applications, both of them are in Next.js. As you can see, next.js.config the other one as well, the Next.js app. And if I go up again, packages, it has UI packages, and these two applications, docs and web, are kind of importing stuff from UI package. So those this is we can call it as dependency inside our monorepo project. And it has this turbo.json and a lot of configurations that you can find them here, and all the documentations are listed here how to work with this kind of project. Yeah, it's good and worth considering in my opinion. So let's go back, and now it's ready. Yes, so if I go to my Turbo repo, what I have, I can run the I exactly don't know, but I can open the project here. Let me zoom, and as you can see, to run this project, let me maximize. Since it's a monorepo project and it consists of different applications, to run every one of these applications, you can just simply open a terminal here and run the project. For instance, from here, I can hit the terminal into CD apps. Let's wait. CD apps, CD web app, and npm run dev. This one, I'm running the next dev. Let's try. Okay, it runs under the localhost 3000 by default. Localhost 3000, as you can see, it's running. And to run the other application, which is web, here you can simply do the same. It's not the one, but also this one is with us. Okay, this is the one, my repo, my turbo repo. To run the docs, you can do the same and run it under, yeah, this is under another port. You can run it individually and independently. I can run it, and it's running under 3000. I can open it here, and this is the docs application, as you can see. So that's it from installation, and see you in the next one.